Okay, tadi kan Miss dah cakap earlier, tiga gas laws yang contribute kepada ideal gas equation is PV equals to nRT. Boyle's law kita tahu volume is indirectly proportional to 1 over P, but if let's say you want to include the proportionality constant, it's going to be PV equals to K. And Charles law pula dia cakap volume is indirectly proportional to T. Kalau you nak include the proportionality constant, it's going to be V over T equals to K, while Avogadro's law pula is di mana volume is directly proportional to number of moles. And if you want to include the proportionality constant, it's going to be V over N equals to K. So, ideal gas law PV equals to nRT ni datang daripada ketiga-tiga gas law yang Miss dah cakap tu lah. Kiranya you gabungkan mereka punya statement tu. So, we will get that. Volume is directly proportional to number of moles dan juga temperature, but inversely proportional to pressure. Okay, tak pun kalau you bawa ni atas, it's going to be pressure times with volume. And then mereka ni directly proportional to the number of moles dan juga temperature. But then if let's say you nak include the proportionality constant, that is when the proportionality constant tu diganti dengan R. R ni apa? R ni adalah gas constant, ya. Yeah? Okay, gas constant ni, value of R ni akan dibagi dalam exam. And R ni actually dia ada dua value. Tapi you jangan tersilap ya. Kalau let's say you nak guna ideal gas law punya equation. Okay, R tu, R untuk gas constant untuk ideal gas law is 0.08206 liter. Okay, this is the unit yang akan digunakan untuk volume, liter. Okay, this is unit yang digunakan untuk pressure, which is atm. This is unit yang digunakan untuk temperature, which is kelvin. And this is the unit that is going to be used for number of mole, which is mole, per mole. Okay, so kalau let's say you nak guna equation, ideal gas law punya equation, which is PV equals to nRT, you have to make sure all of the items here, pressure, volume, number of moles, dan juga temperature, must be according to the SI unit. Before this, kalau you belajar Boyle's law, Charles law, Avogadro's law, kita tak kisah pun Boyle's law ni nak dalam unit apalah, volume ke pressure ni, we don't care. If it's in millimeter mercury ke pressure ni, ataupun if it's in milliliter ke volume ni, we don't care. Charles law, the specific temperature must be in Kelvin. Okay, kalau let's say Charles law dia spesifikkan temperature ni must be in Kelvin, volume dia tak spesifik nak volume in whatever unit. Avogadro's law pun dia tak mention volume ni in whatever unit, tapi number of mole, unit dia mole lah. Okay, kalau let's say you gunakan gas law ni step 1, equation untuk melibatkan gas law step 1 ni yang berasal asing ni, tak kisahlah dia punya unit apa. Tapi once you nak guna ideal gas law equation, you need to follow the SI unit according to each item here. Kalau pressure, pressure kena in atm. Okay. Volume, volume kena in liter. Number of mole, number of mole kena in mole. Temperature, temperature must be in Kelvin. Okay, R pula, R ni gas constant. Apakah unit gas constant? Unit gas constant ni, inilah dia, panjang-panjang ni. Actually, from ideal gas law equation, it can be used to determine density, molar mass, temperature and pressure of gas. Temperature and pressure of gas dengan volume tu benda biasalah. Tapi macam mana you nak tahu density dengan molar mass pula? Okay, density dan molar mass can be known by using the equation PV equals to nRT. Tapi you kena derive lah, okay? Kita tahu that number of mole is equals to mass over molar mass. So, apa lagi? You masukkan mass over molar mass ni pada N. Okay, so it's gonna be PV equals to mass over molar mass kalikan dengan RT. Okay, so if let's say you nak cari molar mass, you can just make the molar mass as the subject and you will get molar mass will be equals to mass times with gas constant, temperature bahagikan dengan pressure dan juga volume. Okay. And you know that density is equal to mass over volume. So, apa lagi? Kita kan kat sini kan kita tahu mass overkan dengan volume kan? So, we can highlight it here. Mass over volume and then substitutekan saja M over V ni dengan density. Okay? So, in conclusion, molar mass is equal to density RT over pressure. Okay, nak tahu density pula, you just switchkan the position here, make the density as the subject. Therefore, density will be equals to molar mass kalikan dengan pressure bahagikan dengan RT. Mudah kan? Jom kita tengok example satu ni. Dia suruh kamu cari pressure in a 200 cm cubic vessel if 12 gram of methane gas is heated to a temperature of 40 degrees Celsius. So, soalan suruh kamu cari pressure and then dibagi volume. Macam mana kamu tahu this information is for volume? Because we know that 1 cm cubic is equivalent to 1 milliliter and 1 decimeter cubic is equivalent to 1 liter. So, kiranya the volume here diberi in 200 milliliter. Okay, and then dia bagi information for the mass of methane gas, which is 12 gram. Methane gas ni adalah CH4, ya. And then dia bagi temperature in 40 degrees Celsius. So, kat sini you tahu you ada volume, you ada temperature, suruh cari pressure, and then you ada mass. So, you know that you need to find the pressure by using the ideal gas law punya equation, which is PV equals to nRT. Since you want to find the pressure here, you will make the pressure as a subject. So, if you susun balik equation, it's going to be pressure equals to nRT over with volume. Okay, sekarang ni pressure ni is something that you want to find. Number of mole boleh cari ke? Boleh. Number of mole ni dekat dalam soalan ni dia tak bagi direct. So, it is something that you need to find. From the mass, you can find the number of mole via equation mass over molar mass. Okay. R gas constant ni is something yang you boleh dapat. The value is always 0.08206 liter atm per kelvin per mole. Temperature must be in kelvin tapi dah dibagi. Although that soalan bagi in degree Celsius, you can always change it into Kelvin by adding 40 dengan 273.15. And last one is volume. Okay, volume pun dibagi juga but then dibagi in milliliter. Okay, the volume kalau daripada milliliter, you want to change it to liter, you need to divided by 1000. Kalau you malas sekali pun nak divide by 1000, you can just put it 200 times 10 to the power of negative 3 liter because it is just the same. Since that times 10 to the power of negative 3 ni is equivalent to divide by 1000. Okay. So now, since kita tak tahu the number of mole ni, okay, kita kena cari number of mole of CH4. So, you know that number of mole is equals to mass over with molar mass. So, you masukkan sahaja information yang you tahu. Molar mass ni is something that you can find, which is the molar mass of CH4 ni adalah 16 gram per mole. So, gram will cancel out with gram and what is left is per mole. Tapi kalau dibawa ni atas, it's going to be mole. So, the number of mole of CH4 ialah 0.75 mole. So, dah jumpa number of mole, apa lagi? Masukkan je lah dalam equation untuk cari the pressure. But make sure every items here must be in standard SI unit, okay? So, sekarang ni you masukkan lah number of mole of CH4, 0.75 mole. The gas constant ialah 0.08206 liter atm per kelvin per mole. Times with the temperature here is 313.15 Kelvin divide by the volume in liter. which is 200 times 10 to the power of negative 3 liter. So you will get the pressure dalam unit atm. How sure are you? Okay, once kalau let's say the benefit of you tulis ataupun substitutkan unit item-item yang diberi ni dalam SI unit dia, kelebihan dia ialah you akan tahu apakah unit at the end tersebut, ya. Sebab you tahu kat sini mol akan cancel out with per mol, liter akan cancel out with liter, Kelvin akan cancel out with per Kelvin, and what is left ialah unit atm yang betul-betul lah unit for ataupun SI unit for pressure. Let's look for the next example. The question asks you to calculate the density of ammonia in gram per liter at 0.989 atm and temperature of 328 Kelvin. So you tahu atm ni unit apa? Unit pressure. So sekarang ni soalan dibagi info pasal pressure, okay, of this NH3, and then dibagi temperature in Kelvin siap-siap. So dia suruh kamu cari apa? Cari density. Okay, macam mana nak cari density kalau dibagi pressure and temperature sahaja, sedangkan density is equals to mass over volume. So you can find the density through ideal gas law equation. Ideal gas law equation adalah PV equals to nRT. So you kena buat a little bit of derivation until you boleh selitkan density dekat ideal gas law equation. And you know, so you kena start dulu by deriving the number of mole here. You tahu number of mole punya formula ialah mass over molar mass. So you masukkan saja PV is equals to mass RT overkan dengan molar mass. So you panjangkan saja macam ni. Okay. So and what's next is, given this equation yang you dah derivekan the number of mole, you kena derive dia until you get that mass over volume, sebab kita nak selitkan density. Okay, so untuk selitkan density, you tahu density equals to mass over volume, you need to bring down this volume. So bila you bring down this volume, the equation now will be pressure equals to mRT over VMR. So now you tengok kat sini, you dah dapat dah m over v. M over v ni ialah formula untuk density. So you just substitute sahaja density kat situ. Now the equation will be pressure is equals to density RT over MR. Okay, so you kena buat derivation sikit. Okay, sekarang ni this density, since kita nak cari density, you need to make this density as the subject of the equation. So it's going to be density equals to pressure kalikan dengan molar mass bahagikan dengan RT. Okay, sekarang ni kita tahu tak information pasal pressure? Yes, we know the information on pressure, molar mass. Soalan tak bagi direct information molar mass, but we know that this gas is ammonia gas. So to find the molar mass of ammonia gas, N campurkan dengan H3, molar mass of nitrogen campurkan dengan 3 kali molar mass of hydrogen, then you will get the molar mass of NH3 is actually 17 gram per mole. Okay, and then the gas constant dah dibagi dah dekat table, which is you know that the gas constant is equals to 0.08206. temperature dah diberi direct in the question, which is it is 328 Kelvin. So after you calculate everything, okay, kita tahu kan dekat chapter 1 density mass ni is in gram, volume in milliliter. In chapter 1 we have learned that the density is equals to mass of the solution in gram divided by volume of solution in gram. But in this case, chapter 5 tiba-tiba je the density unit of gas ni kena in gram per liter. Ha. Huh. Ok, Okay, gram per liter. So it is not something that is weird tau. Chapter 5 je ada exception. Okay, only in chapter 5, the density unit will be in gram per liter. Only in chapter 5. Okay, kenapa? Sebab you tengok sini. Bila let's say you masukkan semua unit yang betul dekat equation ni, bila you substitute with the right unit, okay, so what will happen now, you cancel out kan satu persatu. Macam ATM, you know that ATM boleh cancel out dengan ATM. For Kelvin, will cancel out with Kelvin. Mole negative 1 cancel out dengan mole negative 1. So apa yang tinggal ialah, apa yang tinggal kat sini ialah gram dan juga liter. So that's why lah you boleh dapat the density, unit untuk density dekat chapter 5 special sikit ya, which is gram per liter. Okay. Okay, example 3, dia cakap a chemist has synthesized a greenish yellow compound of chlorine and oxygen and finds that its density is 7.71 gram per liter at 36 degree and 2.88 atm and calculate the molar mass of the compound. So the question wants you to find the molar mass of the compound given the density in gram per liter. You jangan risau. Kalau isi density in gram per liter, ketahuilah this question mesti bersangkut paut dengan subtopic 5.1 about the derivation of ideal gas law equation into mass, into molar mass dan juga into density. Okay, and then temperature dibagi in degree Celsius, so you need to change it to Kelvin. So you kena addkan dengan 273.15 Kelvin. And pressure is already good, which is in atm unit. Okay, so kalau you hafal the equation, senang. You terus buat molar mass ni as a subject of the equation. Sebab itulah you kena hafal dan faham. Kalau tak hafal sekalipun, at least you kena faham. From the PV equals to NRT, kita boleh derive the ideal gas law equation untuk find the molar mass and untuk find the density. Okay, which you know that number of mole is equals to mass over molar mass. And then kita tahu kalau you nak tukar, you nak cari density, you boleh derive bawa je V ni turun bawah. So you akan dapat pressure equals to density RT overkan dengan molar mass. So at least kalau you tak hafal sekalipun, you faham is good already. So sekarang ni, since that you want to find the molar mass of the compound dibagi density, so you can use this kind of equation. Okay, so apa yang you kena buat ialah you just need to make the molar mass as the subject of the equation. So that's why molar mass equals to density RT over P. Okay, in this question is quite direct, everything is quite direct, cuma you kena tukar unit temperature sahaja into Kelvin. Gas constant is something that is given, and you boleh tahu unit dia punya value dia apa dan juga berserta dengan unit. Density dah dibagi by in gram per liter. Pressure pun dibagi by then in atm. So yang perlu tukar hanyalah unit temperature in Kelvin. So you masukkan saja everything else. Okay, kelebihan kalau let's say you masukkan, you substitutekan all of the information with the right unit. Okay, kelebihan dia you akan tahu what is the exact unit yang kamu patut dapat at the end. Okay, so in this case we know that liter here akan cancel out dengan this liter, atm cancel out dengan atm, per Kelvin cancel out dengan Kelvin. What is left here ialah gram per mole. So that's the unit of the molar mass or the compound. Okay. Okay, the last example here is quite unique because you need to plot a graph to find the molar mass. Okay, plot a graph of, kalau say you ada table of pressure dengan density, you kena plot a graph di mana pressure ni akan jadi y-axis, density ni akan jadi x-axis. Okay, so how? Let's continue. Okay, you dapat data di mana pressure in atm, density in gram per liter. And kalau let's say you jumpa saja unit density in gram per liter, please take note bahawasanya mesti soalan ni berkait rapat dengan the derivation of ideal gas law equation. So, since that you need to plot in a graph paper pressure against density, that's why from the derivation of ideal gas law equation, you need to make the pressure as the subject of the equation, okay? Tapi before that, you plot dahulu. Plot dahulu, you ambil kertas graf, lepas tu you plot a graph di mana your y-axis will be pressure in unit atm, your x-axis will be density in unit gram per liter. Okay, so bila you plot atas kertas graf, plotlah elok-elok, janganlah buat kecil-kecil, jangan syai-syai. Buat besar-besar dekat satu kertas graf tu. Kalau boleh sebesar yang mungkin, because you will get a better gradient. So, bila you dapat better gradient, it will be close lah to the Molames tu punya jawapan yang sepatutnya. Okay? So, after you dah plot the graph, make sure you kena plot a linear graph. Okay? So, kalau let's say dapatkan juga a linear graph. Okay, at least ada tiga titik yang you boleh plot a straight line. Okay. After that, you tahulah kan, you punya y-axis pressure, x-axis you density. So, sekarang ni, from a linear graph equation y equals to mx plus c, you kena relatekan with the derivation of ideal gas law equation yang melibatkan density dan juga molar mass. Lepas tu, you susun mengikut this linear graph equation di mana y-axis u adalah pressure. Okay, so we already susun the equation to make the pressure as the subject of the equation, since that y kat depan equals to mx. And the x-axis here ialah density. Okay. And M ni apa? M ni adalah gradient. Okay. M ni adalah gradient. Bukan mass ya, gradient. And your gradient will be RT over molar mass. So, boleh tak cari molar mass kat situ? Boleh lah. Since that, gradient, M ni gradient tau, bukannya mass. Since that, gradient equals to RT over MR. Kita punya main objective here, we want to find the molar mass kan? So, you switch je kedudukan molar mass dengan gradient to make the molar mass as the subject of the equation. Okay, therefore, the molar mass can be found from this graph is equals to R, gas constant. Gas constant ni you boleh dapat, temperature dah bagi dalam soalan, which is in degree Celsius, but you need to change it to Kelvin. Bahagi dengan gradient. Gradient ni mesti tak tahulah. Gradient ni you need to find it on your own. Gradient ni kalau boleh, you mark, you ambil besar-besar, okay? Kalau boleh, daripada hujung sampai ke hujung, dia punya point tu. So, macam kat sini, you akan dapatlah point X yang kedua, Y yang kedua. Ini pula point X yang pertama dan juga Y yang pertama. So, nak kira gradient, formula gradient ialah Y2 minus Y1 over X2 minus X1. Okay, make sure gradient jangan ambil ciput-ciput juga. Ambil paling besar. Okay, point yang paling besar dekat graf. Kalau boleh, hujung ke hujung is better. Tapi, jangan hujung sangatlah. So, after you have found your gradient and then you masukkan, then you bolehlah cari you punya molar mass. Okay?